in this video, you guys, you're gonna see some guy hacking with a charge rifle. Like, I don't know if this is a bug, but like, someone's shooting me through a rock with the charge rifle and a house with a charge rifle, and then know exactly where I am. So there's actually some aim assist going on right there, so it's kind of sus and sketch. We almost won this game versus the hacker too. This is in TPP. So yeah, I mean, I guess there's some hackers in TPP too. I haven't really faced any until now, so that was just one. I didn't really check the name, so I should report it, but honestly, to be honest guys, they should just fix the game. Like, it's just gonna keep dying if people don't fix the hacks. I know the developers are busy updating and making money from skins and cash and grab, but like, can y'all just like fix the hackers and shit? Like, there's hackers in season one and there's still hackers in season three, and there's a lot of hacks, people selling it online and shit. Like, literally people are selling hacks, bro. Like, if you reach FPP Pred and stuff like that, it's gonna face more hackers, right? But same thing if you go higher up too in any mode, like it could be TPP as well. Like, there could be hackers here too. It's just depending on the situation. There could be hackers trying to stream snipe or get more content, or there's just hackers that just want to like face against like pros in FPP to make content, or hackers that just want to chill in TPP and they don't want to get caught. So like, yeah guys, I was not expecting to see this type of BS because I'd never seen a charge rifle hack through a wall before yet. This is new to me. I've seen, you know, people flying, I've seen people speed running, I see people just aimbotting, and I've seen people with soft aim assist. I've seen a lot of people using hacks in certain ways, right? And then the hackers would team up or pred with people too, like, so they would just team up and have their own Discord of hackers and shit, so it's annoying. And there's people selling like stuff to like push to get Predator, because you could buy that if you're hacking, so you could easily push. And you know, there's this guy named Push Pred Paid, it was like Paid Push Buy Now, that was one of his accounts. Yeah, and I landed up here trying to find this freaking hacker. I don't know who it was. It could have been the Ash perhaps, I don't really know. Luckily, like, the charge rifle didn't really, like, I don't know, it didn't fully two shot us. I mean, if it didn't fully one shot us, it takes like two shots, right? So yeah, we saw this fade coming down here trying to get the tag, so we jumped his ass and we got him. And then this is when like we saw the charge rifle dude again hacking. That's, I think there was three squads, I'm assuming, at the very end when we lost. There was this fade and someone else, I think, who was shooting at me when my team dipped me, when they should have stayed by me and we should have fought that. Because they wanted to go around to flank, but I was like, bro, there's not enough time, just stay by me, bro. And then we could have won. Eventually, I revived my third friend from a distance because I did not want to get revived nearby and they shoot us, so yeah. Obviously, like, you know, if there's hackers and stuff, you really can't really fight them unless you know where they are. So until you figure out where they are, you really can't do much. So you see, it's just three squads, just two other squads up, so there's probably one hacker guy with charge rifle, and then there's another person. I mean, I don't really know. I mean, I feel like if the hacker was helping the fade win, like, what? Like, why was the hacker helping the fade, you know? Like, so it's definitely the fade's team, in my opinion. I think the hacker was definitely on the fade's team. It was probably Ash fade or something like that. I don't know. All I know is, like, it was kind of BS. Like, if my team didn't leave me, we could have won this game. We could have beat the hackers, but yeah, whatever. Moving on to the next game. In this game, I'm playing with Tech Dog and some random dude. Dude, G7 smacks, bro. Like, I love the G7 3030. It's pretty nice. Especially if you get hit fire with that thing in shoulder mode, which is kind of unique, because in FPP, it's easier to hit that thing. But in third person, it's like, just like, it feels weird, right? And I remember I was killing this guy who was running away. It was like a Loba, I think. And then she teleported. She tried to fly away. And so as she was flying away, bro, I'm beaming as much as I can with RE45, but I'm not hitting it because there's no range. And then I finally get at the very top with the Spitfire and I got her. I was like, yes, let's go, bro, it reached. So yeah, some guns can have range, some guns don't have too much range. And yeah, after that, we went to this area. We found some people down here. So as soon as I saw that, I was like, let's jump this dude. I went for this rock specifically because I remember sometimes people would jump me from this rock. And after they would jump me, you can't see them if they're from there, so you just hide in that rock behind. So I used that other rock to hide behind, and then we kill them, right? Then another guy landed near us, so I heard that. I snared them, I ulted, and then he couldn't do anything. He got stuck. He was definitely destroyed. Like, this Ash had no idea what hit him. was honestly just dead. He should have never just showed up. Should have never just rushed in like an idiot, bro. Bro. And then the last person, I think, you know, they were bots. Like, I don't really know. All I know is, like, there were people right over here. So I choose my Spitfire out and I ulted across to get a better view. And then I use a Spitfire to kill them. They're dead. You know, honestly, Tech Dog, take my kill again. Go ahead. Every single time I play rank, if I'm playing like with teammates or friends and I shot call or whatever, like I get close to killing them, but then my friends always kill them. Then I noticed the Wraith below, and it was a real Wraith actually. Like, they were trying, but they were not that good. Like, they just got wrecked 1v3. So he's voiding away, he's trying to get away, but one's under, one's above him. Then I crouch to see where he is, and I see him shielding up, and then boom, he's dead. My last video was so intense, so you guys gotta check this one
out. Happy Halloween, everyone. Enjoy the game rank play where me and my friends pop off in clutch. He had 1,000 ping. I won with the guy with 1,000 ping. That's so crazy. All he did was have to listen to my shot calling to win, because even if he's lagging, he can trust my shot calling, my mic. And so yeah, that's what I did. So first off, we were already dead because of the zone behind us. One of my friends already died. If you're wondering why the quality is so bad, it's because my recording didn't save fully, so I only showed the last minute. So I'll show you guys that with better quality. My friend just got down after he traded. We killed this Caustic, I sniped him down. Then Lifeline, he traded with Lifeline. Someone else sniped him. And then I was only needing to kill the Bloodhound, right? Because the Bloodhound killed my friend. And then I just tried to shoot him, but he had red armor, and then I couldn't win. Then I went behind the rock, and my friend had a self-revive because my other friend that had a self-revive gold backpack, and I gave him that gold bag so he could revive, and you know.
Void. It's a fade.
You're gonna reload. You're gonna
Bro, kill him!
Not good, bro!
Right now. Just kill him, please. Thank you. Oh my god. Shield it up, shield up. Watch out for the back.
So basically, I was really intense and I told him the fade is low. Like, I cracked him a bit. Just shoot him. He's dead. I'm really low. And I'm glad my friend did eventually kill him because of my snare caught him. But like, honestly, bro, it was crazy right here, because then after that, he killed the Pathfinder. And I was like, chill, bro. You gotta shield up, bro. Shield up. And as I turn this corner, I see him under me because I'm in third person. So I could crouch and shoot him a bit. So when I shot him right here, I got him kind of low. And then he killed me. And then my friend just finished him off and got him. So I had like 5 kills, 7 assists this game. It was really crazy. You know, like, all these are real people, so like, it's crazy how TPP games can be, especially like really late at like rank at 3 a.m. like, you try this shit on the weekends and stuff, it's crazy. Like, on the weekends I see it, on weekdays not so much because it's like slower matchmaking. But like, yeah guys, like, I hope you guys like and enjoy like the action and everything. I have actually a lot more Ash gameplay to post on, but I just wanted to make this one separate video so you guys can see like how crazy TPP rank is. Like, oh my god, I love Ash. I even made the skin and crafted this skin that's like 1500 from the Halloween like seasonal vault. But yeah, I really like the skin. I love Ash. You guys really gotta try playing Apex Mobile with Ash. It's so fun. And if you really want to see how I do like the first time solo carry,